Welcome to our live session. And I'm very happy to share this time with you. I have a request. Those who can, if you can activate your camera, turn it on. If you can, it gives a good feeling to see all the faces. And the topic of today is a question. And the question is, why is our planet in trouble? To answer this question, I'm going to use some points of philosophy that are presented in our 99 Days to Transform Your World course. If you are not attending the course, or if you haven't attended the course, it's not a problem. I will give a background. And I'm also going to ask you some questions using the Mentimeter. We are going to post the link for the Mentimeter in the chat. And if you click on the link, you can interact with me during the presentation. And make an effort to participate as much as you can with the Mentimeter. It is anonymous. All your answers that you type are anonymous. Feel free to express your opinions. The goal of human life, as we learn in the module 3 of the 99 days course, so the goal of human life is not something material or limited. To become successful in the material world or to accumulate wealth or fame is not really what we human beings really want in this life. Our goal is not external. We can only find it if we go within us, going deeper and deeper within our own minds. We are looking for something that is limitless and everlasting. About human beings. We learned in the module 6, which was about yoga cosmology. And we learned that there's a cycle that starts from consciousness. And then it passes through a stage of cosmic mind and then reaches to matter. So consciousness becomes mind and becomes matter. And then it returns from matter to unit mind, and then back to consciousness. In this cycle, we human beings are the last step. We are the last step on the movement back to consciousness. And all other beings, they are intermediate steps. So our mind is moving from an undeveloped being to a more developed being, a more developed, let's say, plants, animals, and then the mind comes to human. And that's the last step, the most evolved being. So the mind moved from body to body as it develops. So as the mind develops, it can manage a better or a more developed body. So it, let's say, ends a life in an undeveloped body. It goes to a life in a little bit more developed body and more developed, finally, human. And humans, let's say, we are supposed to be the most developed being on this planet. Because we have a clearly reflected consciousness. And that reflected consciousness makes us able to meditate on the consciousness within. This doesn't mean that all human beings are doing that. So many of us have a human body, but we are not really using this human body as it should be used. So in that case, if one is having a human body, but is not really using it as a human body, then it is no better than an animal, even can be worse sometimes. So let's look at human beings. So in this introduction, I wanted to establish the idea that we are really looking for something that is not limited. We are looking for limitlessness. That cannot be found outside in the external world. It can only be found within us. We can say it is happiness or peace, but not the kind of happiness and peace we are used to in our daily life. That is limited. We are happy, sad, in peace, and then disturbed. No, we are looking for that happiness, that peace, but limitless. I also wanted to establish with this, the introduction, our connection with the planet. And all beings on the planet, we are connected intimately to all these beings. It's like they are our family. Even inanimate beings. And we are a product of the planet. In fact, we are the most developed product of this planet. You know, there were no human beings before. There were not even plants and the planet was maybe just gases, then it became a little bit colder, and then liquid came up and solid, and then different beings started, more developed, finally came human beings. So we are product of this planet. Now, with this in mind, we can think, what should we be doing on this planet? And what should be our relationship with other beings? I'm not going to answer it now. I want to ask you questions. And now you can use the Mentimeter. Click on the link to answer the questions. So this first question is, what is the problem our planet is facing that most worries you? It's a word cloud, so answer in few words. one or two words like that. What is the problem our planet is facing that most worries you? Use that Mentimeter. Okay. Some answers are coming. I will wait a little bit. Let more answers come, then we'll comment. Keep in mind that the words that become bigger are the ones that more people choose. Okay. Words are dancing in front of us. Let's see what we get. Climate change is a big one there. And egoism means selfishness is another big one. And I will read a few more. Let's. Okay, so let's look now. Climate change seems to be winning. Selfishness, because selfishness is also here, that is in English and also in Spanish. Hate is also a little bit big. Poverty is also here quite big. And we have a number of, okay, selfish nature of humans, greed of humanity. Mancanza di consapevolezza, it means lack of wisdom. Lack of empathy, human ignorance, overconsumption, the economy, war, consumerism, human greed, the imbalance in the natural conditioning, detached from nature, ignorance again, fear, disconnection. Okay, I think we got the message here. But I will follow up with another question. Are the problems that worry you the most caused by human beings or by nature? You have three choices: by human beings, by nature, and by both. I think the majority is going for caused by human beings. You know, in the past was not like that. People will go out of the house and they don't know if they will be attacked by some animal. So nature was the biggest problem. But nowadays, it seems human beings, we are the problem.
We have in the chat, we have Nita Prima said, it's a tricky question because we're part of nature.
Yes.
And I mean, Soma said people also. So some people are answering in the chat because they're having some okay. trouble with the mentee.
Okay. All right. Yeah, I see here. Oh, somebody said that capitalism is a big problem of society. Okay. War. Yeah, it's a tricky question because we are part of nature, but I'm making it like more specific part. all nature except human beings. And all right, so it seems we are the cause. So let's see. I have more questions. Don't worry. Let's see the next one. Why do you think we are causing all these problems? This is an open question, so you will need to type it. So I give you some extra time to type your reply. Okay, so answers are coming. I'm going to translate this one here. Okay, so let's go. First one is this one, selfishness and accumulation. Again, selfishness, ignorance. Greed. In seek of happiness in an external world. Selfishness and greed again. We like to be comfortable, even at the expenses of the rest, at whatever cost it takes, and fear to lose, and fear to lose it, so we accumulate. And this one is because the human mind is distorted. For selfishness. Because we feel separated from the whole. Ignorance, selfishness. Again, here, ignorance. People who aren't as smart as me and don't think like I do. Greed. And again, ignorance. And greed, anger, envy, jealousy, hatred. We are the cancer. Okay, sounds bleak. Selfish greed, we must come first. Mesquinidad means being small in thought. People are focused on their own interests, selfishness. Yes, I think we get the message here. Many don't understand the basics of spirituality. Let's say even the basics of life, you know. Inner subconscious fears, insecurity. Because we are part of solution as well to the problem. Yes, okay. Okay, let me move forward. Let's talk about our role. What is the role of human beings? So if we are the most developed beings on the planet, what should be our role? So that also is an open question, so you have to type. The first one is a very nice one. I will wait a few minutes more for more answers. Okay, I see some here on the something. Okay, it's in the, I think we talk about all those that came in the chat. All right, so let me start commenting here. Caretaker of all beings. Self-realization and service to creation. Preserving the planet. Think about others, inanimate, animate, including ourselves. Role model. See this one. Connect, meditate, share. Ejemplo en nuestro entorno. We should be an example. Mejorar la convivencia con todos. It means to make it better, our relationship with all. Our role is to walk in harmony with the earth power and to nurture the planet and all our relations. That's a nice one. Live by the philosophy of new humanism, which we talk about in the 90 days course and 99 days course, and many of you know. Let us put others' well-being in front of ours. Try to do as much we can do as per our capacity. Bring the most happiness to the world as possible, to the most beings as possible. We should be love generators. Feel our brotherhood. Understand ourselves and being a responsible person. Leading people towards better life. I think I get your point, and I think we are all very much connected here in our answers, in our thoughts. Our collective mind is quite tuned. Now, I will ask one last question before I comment. How could we help solve these problems? How can we create an impact? How can we help solve this problem? If anybody needs Portuguese translation, there is Portuguese translation now. Se alguém precisa de tradução em português, tem tradução em português agora. All right, so that was just an announcement. You can use the link to answer in the Mentimeter. Don't use the annotate. All right, so let's look at your answers. Okay, let's go now. Do as much as we can as per our capacity. Okay, that's similar to the other one. With intelligence and love. With healthy education from the beginning. listen to others and invite them to the path with judgment. Old quote, think globally, act locally. Yeah, we need to do something. By thinking not about the ends, but the means as well, we're acting that way. Charity. Be present, kind, and use our talents. Kindness. By starting with ourselves and being a good role model. Yeah, that's a good one. Applying Prout. Okay, Prout also, we talk about it in one of the modules of the 99 days, and I think many of you know. Meditating, the mind will be bright. Universal love. We need to be a moral and ethical example. Here also, giving example of our values. By having a good mental, spiritual, and physical health. Meditation, coordinated cooperative efforts. Service. Mindful consumption. Okay. All right. Okay, so let me move forward here. A few thoughts. I want to add these few thoughts just to conclude the presentation. In the past, we were not many human beings, and our technology was not so developed. So our impact was not significant, and nature balanced our actions. If we polluted the environment, then the planet had capacity to clean it up. If we killed animals, they were able to reproduce and keep the species alive. But with the increasing population and the development of our technology, we were able to invent tools and machines that increased our capacity to impact the environment. We forgot that what we really need to do on this planet, in this life, is to develop our minds, to reach very deep within and merge with this infinite consciousness, the only limitless goal that can satisfy us. We have also not awakened to the fact that being the most developed being on the planet, we have a responsibility towards all other beings and the planet. We have the responsibility to take care of everyone. So let's say that we are in a situation that we are doing damage to the planet. And because our impact is very strong. And if we think that, oh, we have to go back how it was before. But you know, there is no going back. There is only going forward. So at present, we are impacting the planet in a destructive way. As we move ahead in the future, we have to care for the planet because the planet naturally may not be able to support the impact that we have. So it means that we will have to help it. We will have to use our technology to help this planet survive and maintain us. So there is only a moving ahead here. So why is our planet in trouble? It's because of our own ignorance. We don't know why we are here. We don't know what is our goal. We don't know what's our responsibility. If we ask people in general on the streets or our friends, maybe family, what's the goal of life? They may not even want to talk about it. So it's very important that this knowledge be spread. What is the goal of life? What is our role? What is our responsibility?